Hello, hello, guys. Welcome back to Opening Bell with Kristen Schoeller and Baker Machado and comedian Michelle Wolf. She delivered a scathing performance at the White House Correspondents' Dinner over the weekend. She criticized everybody from the president to the media to the White House Press Secretary Sarah Huckabee Sanders. Here's a little look of some of the things she said.
I actually really like Sarah. I think she's very resourceful. Like, she burns facts, and then she uses that ash to create a perfect smoky eye. Like, maybe she's born with it. Maybe it's lies. It's probably lies.
I actually thought it was hilarious. Okay, joining us now is our friend Emma Vigilip, Young Turks political host, and so much more, producer over there as well. Emma, great to see you here as always. Michelle Wolf, very funny. You got to know what you're getting with somebody like Michelle Wolf. This is essentially her MO anyway, most of her comedy routine. Did she go too far, or was this speaking truth to power?
Absolutely not. In fact, I would say that the journalists that are saying that she went too far are actually not doing their jobs. They're supposed to hold the power accountable, and instead they're worrying about the powerful's feelings. I didn't go to journalism school. I'm not a fancy reporter like the people in the White House Correspondents Association, but I think I read that you're supposed to challenge the powerful, not defend them at every single turn. And I could care less about Sarah Huckabee Sanders' feelings. This is a roast. It's meant to go after the people in power, the people who are making these important decisions about everyday Americans' lives. And the fact that journalists are outraged about this is more of a microcosm of the problem of the White House Correspondents' Dinner, which is that they're getting cozy with the very people they're supposed to be holding accountable, and that's why they feel so bad for them when they're roasted.
Well, I wonder, too, if journalists this time around are a little bit more upset, because one line in particular stuck out, right? In regards to Trump, he has helped you sell your papers and your books and your TV. You helped create this monster, and now you are profiting from him. And some journalists say, hey, hold on a second. That is not the case.
I disagree. I know that that line definitely hit close to home for them, but studies have shown that during the election, the corporate media or the mainstream press provided him with $2 billion in free media, and they created this monster. They let him skate through the primary, and I know that his Republican primary opponents were like, hold on, why aren't we getting the airtime? It's because he was a clown and he was good for ratings. And then, for example, once he won the primary and Bernie Sanders was still kind of fighting, they were showing Trump's empty podium instead of showing Senator Bernie Sanders filling up stadiums. So he really was their creation because he was such a ridiculous individual and did provide them with such fodder. I also would say that when they were able to talk about his outrageous statements, it didn't allow them to focus on policy, and sometimes they can be called biased if they focus on policy. So it was a win-win for them, but a lose-lose for the country.
The president, of course, tweeted about it over the weekend. He also tweeted about it in the last hour. He said the White House Correspondents' Dinner is dead as we know it. This was a total disaster and an embarrassment to our great country and all that it stands for. Fake news is alive and well and beautifully represented on Saturday night. Over the weekend, he was tweeting maybe somebody like Greg Gutfeld of Fox News should take over and do something like this. In an effort to maybe get the president to finally go to the White House press dinner, should the Correspondents Association maybe take somebody that the president really likes and bring them in?
Absolutely not. I think it's an excellent thing that he isn't going, because it shows that the press are doing their jobs when it comes to Trump. The media and politicians should not have a cozy relationship. It should be an acrimonious relationship. I mean, even when President Obama was in office, I will say that the media was treated him with kid's gloves. You don't hear that a lot from a progressive pundit. But when Obama increased drone strikes and did way more than President Bush ever did, they never called him out on it. When he cracked down on whistleblowers, other journalists, they never called him out on it. Now they've woken up and realized, yes, maybe we did create this monster in Trump, and they're calling him out, but really not on policy. They're calling him out because he offends their sensibilities, and that's the whole core of the issue with their outrage about the White House Correspondents' Dinner. Oh, you insulted the powerful. The powerful should be insulted, especially if they're involved in this kind of administration. I understand that maybe they thought that they were attacks about her appearance, but I don't see that at all. I thought Michelle Wolf did an excellent job.
So, yeah. Look, President Trump obviously didn't go. I'm not so sure he's ever going to go unless there is some dramatic, monstrous, major change, basically. But I did think it still sent a message with Sarah Huckabee Sanders going, and with Kellyanne Conway going as well, right, that there is still some hope of trying to get the administration and at least some people in the West Wing, right, to work together with the press?
Yeah, I mean, I would say that maybe Sanders going, she has to go because that's her job, is to deal with the press.
And Kellyanne Conway likes talking with the press,
and Kellyanne Conway loves attention, so there's that. But I don't know if there's hope as much as there needs to be some sort of bridge between the Trump administration and the press, because I think that's what maybe the White House correspondents would argue, is that, hey, you know, we can't go too hard on them because then we won't get access from them, and then we won't be able to report on the stories that we need to hear. That would be their side of the story. But I think that if journalists as a whole decided to say, no, we're going to do away with that old standard, we're going to hold them accountable, they need to get their stories out there, the administration. So they'd still come to the press, even if they are, you know, aggressive against them. So the press all has to stand up together.
Does the president, though, have a point, though, that maybe the White House Press Correspondents' Center is dead? Maybe they should do something to spice it up a little bit, maybe have two comedians, maybe get rid of the comedy aspect altogether, and maybe do a musical performance? Or do people actually care about the White House Press Correspondents' Dinner? It feels like President Trump's fan base cares about it because they can go to it and say, listen, this is what we're talking about, that they're against President Trump. But this is President Trump's tweet just a few hours ago. I am almost curious if they just need to blow the thing up and try something completely different now.
Or nothing at all. I mean, why do we have to have a celebration where the powerful and the press are hanging out and being buddy-buddy? Because then this is what happens. Then they are apologizing for a comedian going after them, saying, that was too far. That's what happens when you have this cozy relationship. And then it's just natural. It's human behavior. You become friends with those people and you don't want to hurt their feelings. But you can't. That line is blurred then, and that's what the White House Correspondents' Dinner represents. I've seen numerous op-eds today saying that they should do away with the whole thing altogether, because from an outside perspective and for a regular American watching it, it's the elites just like hobnobbing together, and that's why the American media as an institution is even more distrusted than Congress.
Okay, let's talk about quickly the White House Correspondents Association president in a response to what happened. Last night's program was meant to offer a unifying message about our common commitment to a vigorous and free press while honoring civility, great reporting, and scholarship winners, not to divide people. Unfortunately, the entertainer's monologue was not in the spirit of that mission. That's a pretty forthcoming statement there.
I thought that was embarrassing, and I think they should be embarrassed by that statement. They are not backing up their own. They knew what they were getting when they signed, when they put her into this position, when they said she was going to be the comedian there, and now they're essentially stabbing her in the back for doing what she's supposed to do, what every comedian has done, what Stephen Colbert did when he was the comedic guest at the White House Correspondents' Dinner, holding the powerful accountable.
Right. Emma Vigeland, politics host for the Young Turks. Great to always see you, as always. Thank you, Emma.